Hello dear students, so here we are with the fifth video in our concept clarity video series, right? The topic which is picked up for today is from costing, right? So costing is a theory come practical subject, and today's small concept but very important topic is reconciliation between the costing and financial profit. Costing profit, you derive it from the costing P&L when you prepare separate books for costing, that is non-integrated accounts, right? So you get the costing profit, and you get financial profit from your final book of accounts, that is your net profit P&L account, your financial statement. Now these two profits will be different. So reconciliation is a question which is asked for 4 marks to 8 marks. And it is very scoring if you understand the concept, right? First thing is this, whenever they are asking, either if they are asking based on memorandum reconciliation statement, then you prepare it in ad-lib format. If they are asking you prepare memorandum reconciliation account, then you prepare it T format. I will teach you in ad and less format, and the logic is same. If you have to do T format, whatever is ad you have to credit, whatever is less you have to debit, right? So let us start memorandum reconciliation statement to reconcile costing and financial profit, right? So now the first very important thing, where we are standing. Are we in the costing profit? Or are we in the financial profit? You can start with anyone, but preferably we should start from the costing profit. So suppose if I start with the costing profit, I have to do some items add, some items less, and then finally down I will get the profit as per financial statements, right? So now if the costing profit given to you, you have written it on the credit side, first thing to be added is all those income which are taken in the financial statements but you have not taken, like profit on sale of furniture, dividend received, they are all taken in the P&L credit account but you have not taken it. So now you add it, and see, all this is a reconciliation statement. We are doing it on a paper pen, that is, it's not a part of books of accounts. We are not doing any changes anywhere. We are just seeing why there's a difference in the costing profit and financial profit, right? So in the costing profit, as discussed, now the first item to be added is all those incomes which are credited in P&L account, you also credited, so that costing credit P&L credit is same. Now so many expenses we don't consider while preparing the cost sheet, like loss on sale of fixed asset, income tax paid, dividend paid. These are actually the expenses which are debited in the P&L account and your profit is down, but you did not take it in the costing. So now you deduct it from the costing profit. These two items are clear, right? Now we'll go for the overhead charged. In financial books, all the expenses are recorded on actual basis. In cost sheet, all the expenses are recorded on some predetermined basis. Like I may charge factory overhead as a percentage of labor or per unit. So suppose I have charged factory overhead 10 rupees, whereas actually factory overhead is 12 rupees. So I have charged less expense in the costing books. So it is under absorption of overhead. See, don't get confused, ma'am, kab under absorption, kab over, where you are standing. I am in my costing books. In costing books, if the factory overhead is 10, in financial books it is 12, then factory overhead is under absorbed in costing books. So under absorbed means you have charged less 2 rupees, so now you charge it. So if I charge it, what will happen to profit? It will come down. So you should do under absorption less. Don't try to mug up ki under absorption add hi karna, isko less hi karna, you go by the logic, right? Coming to selling expenses, in costing it is always said, charge selling expenses on number of units sold. Here selling expenses are actually incurred, whatever, commission, delivery van, depreciation and all those. So again, selling expenses are 20 rupees. We have charged here 22. Have we overcharged? So now it is over absorption. So if I have overcharged, my costing profit is less because expense is more. So to reduce the expense, what will I do to costing profit? Add it. So over absorption of overhead, add it. Now come to stock valuation. In cost sheet, how do you value closing stock? See, you value raw material in the cost sheet up, then factory, work in progress after the factory overhead, then finished goods after the administrative overhead. You get cost of production and you charge closing stock, you deduct it. So some predetermined basis. In financial books, closing stock as per AS2. So suppose in financial books, closing stock is say 50 rupees. In costing books, you have charged 48. Now what has happened? Undervaluation of closing stock in costing books. Whatever is happening, we have to correlate and we should do the adjustment. We can't ask others to do. We need to adjust it, right? So in costing books, we have charged only 48 closing stock. In financial books, it is 50. So you have charged 2 rupees less closing stock. Lower the closing stock, lower the profit. So my profit is less. So now what I should do? Add undervaluation of closing stock to my net profit, costing P&L profit, to get it correct profit, right? Same way, say in costing books, opening stock is taken as 8, whereas in financial books, opening stock is taken as 7. So again, you have done overvaluation of opening stock. In costing books, overvaluation of the opening stock means you have debited more, your profit is less. Now what you should do? So these are the logics. I know it's a very tough way to interpret all this. Ma'am, ek format bata do, hum kar lenge and finish. No. But when you understand this, put your hands, try to answer 3 or 4 questions which you have been given in your material. You'll be able to solve them all. One more thing. So many times in the exam, this comes for 12 marks also. Now that, how that is it? It's not only the reconciliation, sometimes they'll give you the all the details and the financial account. So first you will have to prepare the cost sheet and financial detail is there, then you reconcile both of them, right? So this is the way how you do reconciliation of the costing profit and come to financial profit. If financial profit is given, you can still go to costing profit. And the toughest level is, if reconciliation is given in the exam, means already the add and less is done. Reverse, can we prepare? Right? See, when funda is there while teaching costing, I have experienced every chapter left to right to left, everything is there. You should know Rowan-Hunsif formulas. From formulas, you should know how to calculate the hourly rate. Standard variances, you should know. If variances are given, reverse, you have to know. And don't think theory is very important. That I know that you all also know that 22 to 28 marks costing mein theory aati hai. Don't sit at a time ki okay chalo shuru karte hain, we'll finish theory. Whenever you are doing 2 subjects, keep things like past exams, RTPs, some suggested answer handy on your table, hard copy. So at least pick up and do at least 1 or 2 questions every day. 1 or 2 theory questions every day, like cost reduction, cost control, debt securitization, bridge finance. These are the questions which are repeatedly asked, right? So practice the theory question and try out these and let me know the feedback whether you have followed this reconciliation concept or not, right? Wish you very all the best. May the best come to you always. Work very hard. Sab kuch chhod do, sirf padhai karo. To bring out the best in you, right? Whatever you are missing, make a list of that. Whatever you are missing. And you know, it's fun when we sacrifice and then we achieve the result. Then till years, you'll be saying all this, your struggle, your story, right? So miss everything and work very hard because you deserve a beautiful future.